The year is 2086. The city is divided between rich and poor. The only way to make it to the top is to enter the Extreme Racing League. Winners are awarded the prize of becoming a Neon Knight, driver for the elite personnel in the upper world, where the rich live.
Neon Knights is a cyberpunk battle racing game for 2 to 6 players and can be played in exhibition mode or campaign mode. Each player will take on the role of a driver entering the league in hopes of beating the competition. Before the game begins, players will draft skill cards to create a personal deck of skills. During the game, you will be able to train and upgrade your driver with cybernetics. Each round represents 1 week, and on each day, players will choose which action to take that day. Before Monday starts, each player will be dealt a betting card. These are bets fans are running. Accomplish these during the race to gain extra casino chips, which is the only currency used by the people living in the lower city. When the week starts, players take turns doing certain actions. Each day will represent 1 action. So you only have 6 actions before Sunday comes, which is race day. You can buy parts from the shop and install them on your car, giving you an edge when braking or accelerating. The stars will tell you how good the part is. Each part is unique and has its own special ability and initiative power number. You can go to the black market and buy special upgrades like weapons, shields, and other enhancements for your car. Trust me, you'll need them during the race on Sunday. You can go to a business meeting to acquire a sponsorship, which will increase your currency and company reputation when payday comes on Thursday. You can draw additional fan bets to see what they are betting on, so you can accomplish more during the race. You can repair your car's armor for 5 casino chips per area on the car repaired. Or you can train by spending company reputation on implants to increase your driver's ability. When each player has taken an action, we move to the next day until Sunday comes. And this is when the race begins. Each race is a rolling start, so each player will choose at what speed they are going to start at. Weapons and special upgrades are locked and cannot be used during the first round of the race. Players will move on the track according to their speed, but have to be vigilant of the threats. Corners have danger lines, and if you're going too fast, you'll roll for damage and might lose fans. However, if you manage to press your luck and drift the corner without taking damage, you'll gain fans. Other players might have weapons, so be mindful of their range and try to stay out of it. If you manage to buy a shield, use it wisely, as they deactivate when you use them. To reactivate any upgrade you used, you need to land on these icons to reactivate the corresponding upgrade. Try to make it through the race with minimal damage, as you will not get any free repairs at the end of the race, and you will need to use a day next week to repair your car. Also, try not to drive badly, as you will lose fans, which becomes victory points at the end of the game, assuming you cross the finish line. Stay with the pack, because once the driver reaches the finish line, you complete the round and the race ends. But don't come in last, because you won't get victory points for the fans you have. At the end of the race, you will gain credits for completing fan bets, but lose and discard all your inactive upgrades. During an exhibition game, you will play 3 races, and the player with the most victory points wins. If playing campaign mode, you do not draft the driver skills, but all skills are available to all drivers. However, you must level up those skills from level 1 to level 3. During campaign mode, you can play as many rounds as you wish, or until a player reaches 70 victory points. Keep track of your player board stats for the next game, and start where you left off. The game will come with lots of components, but help us make it better with stretch goals like a story comic book, synthwave music album, storage insert, larger player boards, and more. Check out Neon Knights on Kickstarter, and if you like it, back it.